It's pointing to a YouTube video that is explaining more or less what we are, what I'm going to show you. So there is a little, this little video explains all the steps you need to set up your own environment. So the, all the installation scripts are collected in the in this link, in this GitHub repository, and you see FutureGateway/portal-setup. It contains many bash scripts that are split in the so-called core scripts. Those are bash scripts meant to support all enterprise Linux version from 5 to 7, the Debian distribution, in particular Ubuntu, and as well as macOS X. I never thought to support Windows, but I will think about it. Inside, there exists this setup config sh that is a file used by the core scripts to keep all necessary configurations for if you want a certain component or not, etc. If you want a particular name for the database, if you want to specify a different host name for the database, and so on. During installation, it is needed by the setup script some binaries. And this is accomplished contacting our demonstrator, SGW INDIGO-DataCloud. So please check the availability of this link before to start any practice section with this setup scripts. In particular, from this host name, following files are downloaded. This is a kind of caching file. For this reason, it's not a mandatory file, but it definitely speeds up the installation process. And then a set of libraries needed for Grid Engine, for instance, and as well as the Feature Gateway itself. As I told you, I would like to find people that could help me to invest some time to develop installation scripts for different platforms. So. As I told you, at the moment, only is fully supported Ubuntu 14.04 server. And in particular, for this system, we have this installation script named fgsetup.sh. Or for Docker instance of Ubuntu 14.04, there is also this script, docker-setup.sh. This second script internally is still using the first script, FG setup. I spent a lot of time to support the EGI FedCloud. So from the FedCloud infrastructure, it is possible to exploit the FedCloud infrastructure to have our own installation of Future Gateway. So to install using the FedCloud, you need the user data. It's a contextualization file needed by CloudInit. So it contains everything to set up our Future Gateway. How do I install it? If you have a standalone Ubuntu installation, you just extract from GitHub the installation file fgsetup, give execution right to this script, FG setup, and then execute FG setup, future gateway, that are the credentials that will be used by the Future Gateway server. The SSH port of where the server is listening on, and then the public key of your own public key. Of course, before to start an execution, it is better to have a look to the GitHub page, the README file in GitHub page. Inside this file, there are also explained some configuration, some changes you need to tune your own installation. If you have a Docker container, extract it inside the Docker image and execute docker-setup.sh. Using the FedCloud, for instance, the video I told you at the beginning of the presentation is using this kind of installation, the FedCloud one. And the demo I will do now, it's very close to the FedCloud installation. I will tell you why. You have only to get the contextualization script userdata.txt, change some values inside this value to configure personal settings. You have to get a proxy from your certificate or from a proxy certificate as you like, belonging to a particular VO, in this case, or FedCloud or the Indigo VO. And you can select one of available endpoints that are supporting the Future Gateway appliance. So those are the tested one are, in theory, you can use any Ubuntu 14.04 virtual appliance. I mean, 14.04 server. By the way, the one tested are at the moment only two. And the image is the first image. Sorry, the second image is the one created specifically for the Future Gateway. The first is a generic Ubuntu Server 14.04 image, always available on EGI FedCloud. So all VOs have this image. So for this reason, I did a test with this specific image. In order to create the EGI FedCloud image, you need to select a resource template, and to do some tests with the Future Gateway, you don't have particular needs. So, for instance, at least one CPU, 1 gig is enough. If you require Liferay, maybe you need to specify a big amount of RAM. I think no less than 4 gigabytes. And let's have a look on the contextualization script. For space reason, I splitted the content of this file in two boxes. On the left side, you have some settings like the host name, some specific cloud init fields. But what is important here is you can specify here your own public SSH key. So if you have many public key, you can put as many rows, as many public keys you have. On the second part, on the bottom of this file, we are specifying the creation of one file. And its name is install-fg. I'm giving execution rights to this script. The owner is root, and this is the content. It's again a bash script that is configuring, that contains some environment variables that you can specify. For instance, fg liferay means you can use 0 to skip Liferay installation. So if you don't need a portal, the specific Liferay portal with your own Future Gateway, you can switch this off. You can, for instance, specify if you want to reboot the machine when the installation completes. This is if you reboot the machine after the installation, you will find the Future Gateway up and running automatically. Otherwise, you have to start it manually. Here you can specify an alternative SSH port. If you don't want it at 22 as a standard, for security reason maybe, you can specify any number here. For instance, in this case, we have this port number 2424. Of course, if you need to contact from external networks this address, this SSH port, you have to enable this port on the firewall to accept incoming connection from outside. Here you can specify the Tomcat user administrative username and password. And then there are other things that you may change that are explained later, exactly here. So inside there's this the install FG. There are some lines like this piece of code in order to switch the content of some configuration variables so that you can specify different, for instance, a different Tomcat username and password. This is the tip using those variables. But you can add your own, just modifying, just keeping this part of script and customize it for your change. The aim of this is to change inside this FG setup SH script the creation of the configuration file setup config. So again, the install FG is something that executes this second script, FG setup SH. This FG setup SH is creating this setup config.sh script. The setup config is the one used by the core script and contains all the configuration variables. So the install FG contains instruction in order to modify on the fly the content of the FG setup.sh. Okay, we can skip this, the GUI for the FedCloud. So as soon as the installation finishes, the FutureGateway can be executed as a service. So you can use init etc initd FutureGateway with the stop, start, restart in order to execute it. And accordingly, normally the front end is executed as a command line, so not with the WSGI configuration. And this can be changed through several configurations that are explained here. And when the FutureGateway operates, you can, for instance, look at the generated log files. This is really useful while debugging or while the daemon is running. And below, you have also the instruction to connect, for instance, to the API server database. There are two utilities named ASDB and UTDB in order to connect to the API server database and the grid engine user plugin database. So you just type these little words to connect directly or execute a query against those databases. So this is what I will show, for instance, the execution of a simple test hello world, because the baseline installation configures itself automatically to run the SSH demo on the same machine. So it sends a hello world job contacting the same host. A similar test is say hello that shows also how to manage input files and arguments. We can skip here database configurations because I already explained. Okay, here I'm explaining about what I can do with the application APIs. And those are configuration variables to configure the front end. So the front end contains a file named fgapiserver.conf containing some important settings, like, for instance, the I/O sandboxing for the grid engine, the keys to for HTTPS connection, if you want to enable HTTPS, the log file, the key used to encrypt the token information, the log token information. This is, for instance, the endpoint for the portal token validation, and so on. This is the section related to the front-end database connection. And this is an example of WSGI configuration that could be useful if you want to set up to run the front-end to run as WSGI. WSGI is highly suggested in case of production environments. And the second component has also its own configuration file. It's a .property files, contains information about the API server database, some settings managing the polling configuration, so the timeout to have polling, how many commands to process per poll, etc. Some few words can be said for the development. It is really easy to do changes and customize this environment. In particular, the front-end and the daemon are in those locations. You can CD on these paths. And currently, the JSAGA adapters developed so far are available also on those paths. So next adapters will come later. You can, for instance, execute a git pull from one of those directories, get the latest version. In case it's a Java code, you just compile with ant all, and you can get fresh, the newest available package. You can watch the behavior of API server daemon, having a look on this path, in particular Catalina out. But the daemon, it's also generating another log file. This is another place you can find in GitHub, FG tools. It contains at the moment only two utilities. This push proxy is an internal utility used for Indigo project. It's not necessary for you to know about it. And this update code is a utility to move, for instance, your local code changes to a running server, and vice versa, you can get files from a remote FutureGateway machine to your local environment. So, for instance, this is how you can use it. By the way, it's self-explanatory. Those are few words about the utility ISDB and the UTTB. And the finally words can be explained on the database migration. So together with the code changes, you can update also database schema because a new version may require a different database schema. In order to keep aligned everything without rescratching the database and losing all existing information about application configuration, infrastructure, etc., there are some, it is possible to run those update so-called patches. So you can apply patches just going on this location, future gateway location, FG API server, and DB patches directory. You can update with the git pull the content of this file. You can realize that there are some changes on the database schema, and just executing this simple patch apply.sh script, the database will be updated automatically. Since this script cannot run as a super user or root in a generic environment, sometime in the log files are explained some warning messages telling you what to do as root to finalize the patch. So, for instance, you have to install a package, and for this reason you need the root privilege.